So if I select all my objects, we'll check up here, we have faces, 584. So I'm gonna round that up to 600. It looks like I'm just shy of 1200 polys. So I have another, 300. So basically 150 more quads that I can add. So I can add a little more detail in this guy. I'm gonna do that. Over here, probably, because this looks like where it needs the most detail. All this is pretty flat and not too bad. So it looks like we're gonna need the most detail right in this face. We could actually add maybe a little mouth up here. But this is the big part right here, this circle. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna kind of change the edge flow of the main fish here to follow that ridge. So just literally, I'm gonna turn off that proportional editing with the O key. It's right here, by the way, if you don't remember the key binding. So you can say connected. The difference here with connected and enable is proportional editing, and for instance, if I have another mesh that's a part of this mesh, so I have this UV sphere, let me turn off the proportional editing totally. So now I have this UV sphere just on, enabled, right? If I select this and the sphere, which is a totally separate mesh combined in with this mesh in edit mode, it will affect that sphere. But if I go over here to connected, it will only do the connected mesh. See, it doesn't affect the sphere at all. Now, this can be really helpful if, say, my eye mesh was connected to this, the body mesh, and I wanted to... Actually, it's maybe easiest just to show you. I'm going to go grab the eye and Control J, join it into the body. Now we can see the eye and the body is together. Now if I wanted to pull these around the eye, but I don't want to mess with the eye, if it's just unenabled, it's going to mess with the eye. But if it's unconnected, you can just kind of pull this around and kind of sneak it together. So let's pull those into separate meshes again. Okay, there we go. They're separate meshes. Let's try to follow this ridge and see what we can do there. I need some more detail, like through here. So if I hit Control R, see, that's gonna add too much detail up towards the nose of the fish up here. So instead of doing that, I'm gonna have to use the knife tool. So I have to decide basically a loop that I want to cut. So I'm going to try to cut a loop right through these, like, maybe like right here. Give myself more detail all through this. So let's go into face select mode, select all the faces I'm going to cut. Hold down the K key, where you want to start cutting, hit left mouse button, and you can just sit here and cut that loop. That'll give me the ability to definitely add a lot more detail into that. And once again, I'm going to need more detail through this. So I might be able to get away with, no, that's going to add detail in a weird area. So it looks like I can probably cut a loop through these. And this is literally just something you really need to practice. Over time, you can kind of start seeing where to cut these loops to get the detail you want. But if you cut a loop here, that should give me the detail I need through this area. Need another set of polys that kind of follows this circle, or like kind of around that, so that I can kind of make that dip out from the rest of the fish. As you can see, like in the reference, it looks like it kind of bulges out ever so slightly there. So basically, I'm gonna add another line here so I can make this bulge out a little bit. Trying to just select the vertices. Middle mouse button with the paint select does deselect. So that's about where that ridge is. Okay. And then I'm just going to hit Alt S does shrink fatten. Let's try it again. Alt S. Ever so slightly pull that out. That's too much. It might even be easier just to move that out with the G key. So G and then X, and just ever so slightly kind of pull that thing out to get like a nice ridge.